Good afternoon, and we're in Sauer Park in New York City, one of my favorite places to go. It's about almost 90 degrees out already. The reason why the video is delayed was because I almost lied to you. So I reshot the video to show you exactly what I did wrong. In the previous two videos, I had issues with the bed and aligning the holes, whatever. It came back to bite me again. And I tried to cover it up. I wasn't gonna show you that I made a mistake, whatever, but I said, you know what? We're a family, we're a community, we all support each other, we're all makers. So, as I said in video one and two and other videos, you learn from my mistakes, hopefully, so you don't make them. And as I said, I'm gonna make mistakes, and I wanna show you what they are and how I corrected them. Anyway, because of that, I'm gonna do a giveaway. So we're almost at 500 people. Once I hit 500 subscribers, I am gonna do a giveaway. I'm gonna give you more details in the video, so watch it. We're gonna talk about the bed, the hardware, and how to put it together, how to count. Counting is very important. We're gonna talk about the Z-nuts, the brass ones, the dowel ones, and the backlash ones. We're gonna talk about bearings. There are a couple different types of bearings you can use for the smooth rods. I'm gonna tell you which ones I use and why I use them. Okay, so don't forget, leave me a comment below, subscribe, let me know what you want to see. If you have any issues, I'm around, I'll answer your questions if you leave a comment below, I promise that. Let's get building. Okay, here we go. This is my Ziploc bag, and I keep all my parts separately for like my motors, my plastic parts for this and that in different bags. So it's more organized that way. And it's easy to check to see if I have all the parts. Right now, I'm lining everything up to make sure I have everything that matches that I need, because if I'm missing something, I can print another one out on my other printer. But you want to do this especially if you only got one printer and you took it apart to do an update, because if you're missing a part or you're short, you're going to have to rebuild it to reprint that part and then take it back apart again, or call somebody else, or find somebody to print that part out for you, and that's gonna put a delay. I also wanna check all my screws to make sure for all the screws matching. And a lot of times what I do is, if I'm that busy, I'll put all the screws in the holes and with a nut, so I make sure I'm not short. Now over here, I had to drill some holes out because the holes were meant for M3s and I'm using M4s, so I wanted to drill an M5 so it slides through and doesn't screw in. This part holds the silicone leveling pads for the heating bed. You want to make sure that you have all the parts. I do, so I'm looking at them right now and I'm going to start building. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to take these nuts and slide them in here sideways, and we're not going to make them super tight. We want them to slide a little bit to the left and to the right. So we're just going to put them on just to fit them in. And we're going to do this a couple of times. We're only going to use three silicone mounting things, and you can see the little circles, they go up like that. Make sure they're all facing the correct direction. Okay, so now we're gonna do the other side, put the third one there and just screw that in tight. Not too tight, as I said before, just tight enough to hold it in place. Okay, that was pretty easy. So now we're gonna go for these parts over here. Now I think this is supposed to be like M25 screws, Z rod things on, but I had a little longer, so that's okay. You know, I'd rather have it longer. If it's too short, it's not gonna work. So I needed something. It doesn't make a difference. It's not gonna affect the performance. You know, go with what you got. Don't wait like 5 days for a screw just to make it perfect. You can always get it later on. Now, what I'm putting on right now are the smooth rod holders. Make sure you have the right ones. The Tronxy comes with the 8mm rods. And I'll go into that in a little bit. There's 8mm, 10mm, and 12mm. I'm using the 8mm over here. Okay, so make sure you print the correct ones. And you'll need four of those on two for either side. Okay, there's two versions of the VzBoT motor mounts. There's a single motor that uses a special belt that's a loop that you have to order. It'll take a couple weeks to get over here. And there's a dual motor mount, which is what I'm going to be using for this, because we can start building without having to order anything. We have two motors and we'll just print out the motor mounts and we're good to go. And everybody has that, so we'll go with that for now, and maybe later on I'll upgrade to the single motor and see how that works out. All right, so let's start talking about the smooth rods over here. I'm going to show you a couple of different LM8 you use. that we have a choice of using right now. We have the stock Tronxy ones, the T-shaped ones. We have the shorter ones. Now, this project calls for the longer ones. I don't have the longer ones. I don't want to order longer ones. But I just want to show you the difference between what I like normally. I like these little, they're kind of like Teflon coated or something like that, but they're super smooth. I prefer using this on the Y-axis because look how quiet that is, okay? Versus a normal bearing here that makes all that noise. Silence. Now, they say this may wear out after a while. I don't know. But this makes a lot of noise. But for what we're using it for, the Z-axis, it hardly moves, so it's going to make zero noise at all. If it was in the X, I would say, yeah, let's nix that. Let's go for the other one. But for this, let's just use these. These are free because they come with the kit. We'll just pop them in like that. It should be a tight fit. You don't need to screw these in. It is going to be good enough. Just put them in, pop them in, whoop, and you're done. Just like that, okay? Just like whack-a-mole. Done. Let's talk about the Z-rods now. Now, these are the brass nuts that most people use, and I am not crazy about them. I prefer the Delrin ones, and I'm going to show you why. Okay, the brass ones, they fly on super smooth like that, right? But I'm going to show you why I do not like them. Okay, watch. They're going to go up and they go down. Look how fast they go. Now, if I just let go, watch, it goes down by itself. Just like that. Watch. Goes up and it slides down. That causes a backlash. You do not want that. That's the last thing you want. But they came up with a little method to fix that. I'm going to show you. It's a backlash kit. So you put the spring over here and then you put this other nut behind it. And so the idea behind this is that the main nut on top for the Z-rod doesn't slip down. All right, watch. So if you try to spin it, the whole thing goes down, but it doesn't really move at all. So it slows it down. Yeah, that works, but you know, I don't like it. I prefer the Delrin ones better than the brass nuts. And I'm gonna show you why. Let me remove this over here. You see how this goes back and forth? Yeah, total crap. Too much hardware. And pop that off. Okay. So now here are the Delrin ones. They're like a type of like super hard plastic, but smooth. Okay. You slide them on just like a normal nut. They're smooth, but they don't fall down. They don't go down. You can spin them as hard as you want. They don't really move, but they're loose enough to move smoothly. You know, they're not tight. They just don't slide down like the brass nuts do. Okay. Now be careful when you order these because they're two different sizes and they both fit the same rod. Look, if I put this on here, it's going to fit like that. And then I can put the smaller one on top. What it is the collar and the top part. It's a difference in size. And you want to get the smaller ones to fit this kit over here. I'll put the link in the description of which ones you should get. If you don't have those, if you want to use the brass ones, by all means, go ahead. You know, it's up to you what you want to use. We're trying to build as much as we can from a stock Tronxy, you know, without the bling. We'll use bling when necessary, but, you know, we're trying to get this as low cost as possible. Okay, so it's time to align the bed. So we're going to flip it over. Make sure all the mounts are loose so we can adjust it as we go. Put the bed upside down like this. We have the screws already mounted on it. And all we got to do is fit those silicone leveling pads onto the screws on all three points. And then we're going to flip it over and then hold the pads because they can fall off. And we're going to line them up with the holes on the little mounts over here. So we can spread that out, put one in, squeeze the other one in, and flip it back over, make sure everything is in properly. Well, here's the part where I was going to lie. Well, not lie, just not show you how I fixed it and pretend everything was good because I was a little embarrassed. But now I'm going to show you exactly how I fixed it and how it works really well. My holes were still messed up. Even though I went to my last video and I showed you how I made new holes, it still did not line up. So I'm going to show you how I fixed that. Okay. I got this thing over here, this screwdriver, and I'm going to heat it up on the stove
And then I'm gonna melt this down just by holding it through the hole and pushing down, straight down. I only kept it for about 30 seconds over the flame. And that should melt it, and I can sand it down or do a little bit more if I need to. But I think that should be good enough. I may just follow it down a little bit, get it smoother. And then I'm gonna put it in and let's see how this fits now. Okay, we put it in there. Boom, 1, 2, 3. Tight, it's not wiggly. I'm gonna put the little pad on there, but I should screw that down because that helps. So put the pad in there and put the mount and then get my nut driver and screw that in, and that should be really good to go. Okay, now that's tight, and I'm gonna flip it over, and I'm gonna show you one more thing I wanna do over here just to get everything kind of lined up properly. As remember I said, keep those things a little loose. This is why. So we can adjust and center this as close as possible. We can do more of this later on, but you know, for now, I'm just gonna do it by finger touch, and we'll see how it looks once we start building this here. Okay, make sure all the nuts are tight on all the sides and all three points. And now I'm gonna put the wheels on. My screws were a little bit short, you know, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna push down on it and then spin the wheels on. And these wheels are a lot bigger than the Tronxy wheels. The Tronxy wheels will not fit on these because these are 4 millimeters. The Tronxy wheels are 3 millimeters. Okay, so you can see there's almost no clearance whatsoever. And what I'm doing now is I'm pushing down on the pads and then putting the wheels on and tightening it just like maybe a turn or two, just like that. And once it's locked on, I'm good to go for the next wheel. So on the third wheel, we'll do the same thing, and that's good. Now we have these nice big wheels instead of those tiny little wheels or nuts, which I don't like at all. And I think we're good with this here. We're gonna put maybe a Z end stop and a cable holder. I'm just gonna put on here for now. I don't think I'm gonna use a Z end stop. I may use my BL Touch instead, but I'll put it here just to show you where it should normally go. And by the way, that power cable should be in the back. I'll flip it around later on and we'll take care of that. And this is the cable holder that can go on that side. It depends, wherever your cable's at, it's up to you how you will do your cable management. And that looks like it's about it. Now, remember when I told you I didn't really care about too much about the scratches on my bed plate? Let me clean this off for a second. I'm gonna show you why. I got this amazing magnetic plate from Filament. It is super thick, has a beautiful magnet, and the best part about it is it's edge to edge. There's no gaps in the side. It's edge to edge. And the plate is thick. It's not flimsy. It has two sides, texture side, and also a smooth PEI side, okay? I mean, I love this thing. I have no complaints. I've used this in the past, you know. This is what I'm gonna be using. It's not bling. For me, it's a necessity to use this here. I don't wanna be scraping things off of a bed plate. Okay, it's time for a shout out to Roger Kolasinski. He bought me a beer on Buy Me a Coffee. More details below. Thank you so much. And speaking of details, here are the details for the giveaway. Once we reach 500 subscribers, which we're only about 120 away, I will give away a free roll of either ABS, PLA, or PETG. Your choice will send it to you. All you gotta do is put a comment below, hit the like button, and subscribe. Those three things, and we'll pick one of you randomly to get this roll. Click, 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 you're done. So, now here are the parts for the Z-axis now. We're gonna put this on the frame, but you know what? We're gonna continue that another time.